Music listening has become an integral part of our daily activity. Right from riding a bike and listening to a headphone, or driving a car, playing some music onto your entertainment system, or even if you have got a soundbar or a home theater setup, you would want to still enjoy music on it. Now, to do all of this, what you need is a good music streamer. And that is exactly what we are going to discuss in this video, wherein we'll talk about various Wi-Fi music streamers available in the market. What do they do? And how should you really buy the right ones? Now, before we dive deep into the Wi-Fi music streamers, let us first understand the entire evolution of music listening. The first one has to be live music, because that was the first impression for anybody to listen to music live in action. Then came an era of recording this live music, and that is the same time when most of the speaker brands came into existence along with the electronics to play back this recorded music using a LP record player, which we also call it as a turntable nowadays. After that, during the world wars, what we saw is the rise of radio broadcasting, and that is the same period when radio started playing music as well. So the tuners and all, they came into that time. Then came in the modern times of listening to music using Walkmans or cassette players. Now, cassette players and Walkmans are still relevant today, and I'm pretty sure many of you would have at least one radio set with a cassette player built in into it. After an era of cassette and Walkmans, there came a big shift in the music industry, and that was an introduction of digital way of listening to music through CDs. Now, these compact discs or CDs, as we all know, are still relevant today, and a lot of people have got huge collection of these CDs to play music in their own entertainment setups. Managing CD library wasn't very, very easy, and that is what pushed people to start looking out for options in a more easy way of listening to music. And that is where the MP3 players and the iPods came into existence, and they kind of literally revolutionized the entire music market. What happened now is that at the end of the fingertip, you could listen to the vast library of the music sources. And then when the internet bubble started bursting in the late 2000s, there came a rise of music streamers, wherein you can play music through Apple Music, YouTube, Spotify, all of these formats. And that is why in today's times, the Wi-Fi music streamers have become a relevant product to have in your entertainment setup. So today, wireless streaming from one device to another has literally become a daily activity. Be it in a car or at home, the world is now shifted to accessing vast library of millions of songs on the fingertips by simply subscribing to the music apps like Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal Connect, and many more. Now, apart from streaming, some of you might even have a personal collection of high-res digital downloads. It can be in the form of CD rips on your hard drives or something which you have just downloaded over the internet. Now, to play all of these across your entertainment devices, you need one product, which is the dedicated network audio player, also known as the Wi-Fi or wireless music streamer. Wireless music streamers are becoming increasingly popular to get any analog system upgraded to support modern day platforms. For instance, an old vintage stereo system at your home from your grandparents' era, or even a simple tape record player that you still enjoy for your cassette music playback, now in the same, you can actually play music on these devices using a good Wi-Fi streamer, and all you need is just an RCA connection, which is the white and the red connection, and you're good to go. Wi-Fi streamers are available in various sizes, shapes, and price range. Right from an easy-to-buy compact models like the Wimpro, Audio Pro Link, Multi-AV, etc., which start from around 20,000 rupees, to all the way up to 2 to 5 lakhs in Arcam, Name, Eversolo, Hi-Fi Rose, Macintosh, Rottel, etc. Now, all these Wi-Fi streamers can allow you to control the music remotely via applications, and you can actually say goodbye to the remote controls that you have been using so far. Apart from that, you can also integrate these devices to modern day voice assistant services like Google, Alexa, or even Apple HomeKits. By doing this, you can simply ask Alexa to play the music in your living rooms or bedrooms very, very easily. Relying on forum discussions and checking the product spec sheet is pretty common trap while buying any hi-fi AV gear, including the Wi-Fi music streamer. Now, one thing you have to understand is that the expectation and the requirement of each individual is different, and it may not necessarily be valid to you. So that's why while buying Wi-Fi music streamers, here are 5 pointers that I feel you need to keep in mind to make your decisions very, very quick. The first one is to know your music source. Well, are you going to use a laptop via USB A to B connection, or are you relying on a Bluetooth connection, or are you going to stream music through Apple Music or Spotify or any other application? Try to see which is the music source for you and go for a music streamer which has got that source compatibility. The second thing that you need to check is the audio bitrate. Now, audio bitrates can be 32-bit 384 kHz or 24-bit 192 kHz. Now, while these numbers look nice, but if you are going to really play music by just casting it through AirPlay or Chromecast, then what you need is only 96 kHz. So, not necessarily that the bitrate being higher will really matter to you if you are not going to use it. The third thing that you need to keep in mind is whether you have got a Wi-Fi connection or are you looking to do an Ethernet connection. If you have got an Ethernet cable in your AV rack, always rely on going for a Wi-Fi streamer with Ethernet so that there is an uninterrupted and a stable Wi-Fi connection to play your music continuously. The fourth one is my favorite because it talks about price. Well, cheaper is not necessarily better when it comes to Wi-Fi music streamers, and I'm not going to really talk much about it because I'm pretty sure that the demo has already given you that clarity. And the last important aspect while shopping for Wi-Fi music streamer is the DAC. Now, in case you are going to rely on the built-in DAC for music, then definitely you have to buy a Wi-Fi music streamer with a good quality DAC, something like a Bluesound Note 2i or even the Audio Pro Link 2. I hope that this video has now given you the clarity on Wi-Fi music streamers and how they can add value to your existing setup. If you have listened to any of this or already possess it, let me know your views on it in the comment section. And I, Tanmay Mehta, your home cinema consultant or home theater wale bhaiya, we'll see you again in the next video. Till then, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much.